We are the Catalan Independentist Resistance, and you are listening to a new update from Radio Hadrian in Free Catalonia.
Children are the most important resource in the world and the best hope for the future. John Fitzgerald Kennedy. Good afternoon, this is David Rabantos. This is chapter 66 of Radio Hadrian. In its English language edition, this project made true thanks to Delia Forrest and Cheryl Scott and KA Radio. This week we'll go on about the National Day in Catalonia, 11th of September. It's been a special week for us, and my blog has started inside our website. We've done the first t-shirts of Directa 68. We've been invited to a radio program of Alex Garcia, Directa Buscadores. We did the first manifesto for our first National Day as a political party. It's been an interesting week. We'll go on to that later. But first, we want to open a line in this program. We're fighting for the independence of Catalonia, but we're going to do that by defending the truth. And we want that not just out of nationalism, which we are not particularly, we're not particularly nationalist, but we want to start a nicer place to live in. And we want to open, and the opening sentence is because this program is dedicated to all the children in the world, everywhere in the world, in all history. We won't go into detail today, but we want to start a series of comments on the awful things, from the abuses the church has done on children or the BBC, till cases in Catalonia and in Spain of murder and ritual murder, rape, all kind of abuse, the kidnapping of children under Franco, the kidnapping of children in the Argentinian dictatorship, the kidnapping of Aborigine children to give them to white Australians. We want to be the voice of those who don't have a voice, and of them particularly one. We're also going to talk about the use of psychiatry with children, and we'll see how vaccination is bringing more disease than ever, so we need to take a look into that. We want to open a series of that, and we don't talk a lot on what we'll do after independence, because we need a critical mass and we need to get away from all the labels to get there. So, but one thing we want to do, because everybody except those that come taking advantage of our most precious resource, our hope in the future, Kennedy said, except that vermin people, that toxic criminal people, everybody else would agree that we need to do the best we can to protect children. So we're gonna focus, we're gonna try to get universal jurisdiction on cases related to children. So we'll try to make Catalonia oasis of protection. We're going to try to be exemplar of what happens in Catalonia, so we have the moral right to try to prosecute things that are not being prosecuted elsewhere. And that entails risk, but risk is what we do here in Radio Hadrian. So we're not experts, so anything you can pass us about abuses in Scotland, anywhere you know of, anywhere in the English-speaking world, we're not experts, but we want to be the voice of those abuses. We want to make this program committed to the welfare of our children. This week we'll talk about the Catalan National Day and how it went for Directa 68. We're going to talk about controlled opposition, and we're going to talk about Joan Vives and Anarquia, which are quite known in Scotland, because This program has forced Joan Vives into the surface after hiding in the gutter for almost 30 years. We've managed to brought him out, to bring him out, because they need to clean him, because we have told a lot of truth about him. So now Spain needed to protect him. It was a brilliant 11th of September. We're so proud. It took us 8 months to become a party. We had tens of people doing the flower offering with us, which is something that normally only 5, like 10 people go to these things. It's not a march. It's just like something you do with people listening to this program, people from far away. They wanted to be there with us, and it was very emotional. We spoke with hundreds of people during the day in our post. 15 to 20 people were there with us. Well, we were only 3 people there, Delia, Gerard, and me, and Luis collaborating with us. Luis from La Gota Catalana, which is an essential person in our lives and in the life of Catalonia. But it was amazing. We gave 7,000, 8,000 flyers. We made our party known. And we had the chances to clarify things about our ideals, our why the logo is the logo as it is, and all these things. And some people came and offered information about infiltration and how they're not very happy with the current politicians and how they want people to organize in a new way. And that's what we're doing. Director 68 is gonna put 68 plus in number. Not that you need to be over 68, because we need a bit more varied parliament. But more than 68 people, men and women, women and men, will declare independence, bypassing the traitors that are occupying our parliament now. So it was an amazing day. We grew exponentially from last year to this year. If we grow exponentially, there's thousands of people who would vote for Director 68. Now, we need to keep growing exponentially to be millions and force elections that will win and declare independence. Another thing important this week has been control to position. What I'm about to say, we have our contacts in Scotland, but we need to find more people which is determined to bring Scotland to independence outside the SNP and about outside everything organized now. The system is organized in such a way that everything you love and respect works for the system. So you need to create your own media, your own parties. Because every media and party you know, they don't work for you. So at this moment, maybe you've got wind of some important thing is we spoke with some people from Scotland, as we did with some people from Flanders, South Africa, Basque Country, Occitan, lots of places. And they told us that they didn't trust the way things were being done in Scotland. So things are not so controlled as some might think when you only look at the media or social media. Anyways, the situation here in Catalonia is, you know, we have political prisons and people in exile, but the real truth, the truth that people listening to this program already know, is that that is all a farce, and those are traitors that avoided independence in October. So the best way Spain had to protect them was to put them in prison to avoid people realizing we've been betrayed. And there's all this thing about yellow ribbons, and there's tension in the street because of the yellow ribbon. There's all these things going on. But the question now is, they're trying anything and everything to put the attention of the pro-indie field against Madrid, which of course is the enemy, the same way as London entails the adversary, the enemy of Scottish independence. But Scottish independence was not murdered in London, was not murdered by English people. Scottish independence was murdered the moment the Edinburgh Agreement was signed, the moment the voting rights were given to IDOCs, the moment no exit polls were put in place, that murdered Scottish independence. So the question in Catalonia is similar. Everybody you know, Clara Ponsatí, Amer Anwar, Carles Puigdemont, Oriol Junqueras, the other people in prison, the prison in Switzerland, Torra, they all work for Spain. You only can murder Catalan Scottish independence from within. They cannot do the same things. They cannot put the tanks in George Square nowadays. They cannot bomb Barcelona every 50 years like they like to do. It's not that different. But they need to do it differently. And the word is infiltration. Infiltration in the highest places. And the question is, everybody you know, so all this thing will sound like Martians to you, because everybody you know works, except for this program and us, works for Spain. So it's controlled opposition, so everything is inside Plato's cave or the Truman Show. And in this line, now the big effort is, a lot of people are opening their eyes to the fact that the things have been done wrong. But now the big effort of Spain is make the traitors look like just incompetent people that didn't do good enough. But that's not the case. And that's where there's a string of actions which are false flags, people sitting in front of Catalan government, but they're greeted by Catalan ministers. I was there a long time doing a hunger strike. I was there long sessions. They never came to say hi to me. And I know some of them for 30 years now. And now you put like three people under a dock. They pretend to do sitting there, and Catalan television go there. Ministers, the prime minister, they keep talking about republic when they should be talking about independence. They didn't come to us. And now people are pushing Directa 68 to try to coincide with these people. Well, all they are is control position. It goes like this. One of the organizers and one of the administrators of the main telegram group of the organization is somebody who lied to me, made me lose my time, stood me up four times, has slandered me in public. And remember, I did a hunger strike both for Scotland and Catalonia. She pretends to be Prendi. She in public said that she wished I had died while I was doing a hunger strike. It's not only that she's not, it's not only that she's a bad person, it's not only that she's unionist. That shows that she works for Spain. Nobody working for Catalan independence would say, the thing is worse because it's a threat, but how can you go? Everything is run by Spain, so I cannot even go to court. She says, I wish he had died while he was on hunger strike. That would have saved us a lot of effort. That's the kind of sentence you would expect from a Spanish policeman, isn't it? Would save us a lot of effort, which means like they would have to finish me off. It's better that hunger had done it instead of them doing it. There's another action of trying to go and register demanding Catalan government to act on the mandate you gave them. And that would be nice if we didn't know that they're barking up the wrong tree. Everybody in Catalonia we know works for the other side. So everything that is to put pressure on them, to support them or put pressure on them is what Spain wants. The only thing is to denounce them and to get them away and to construct an alternative, which is what we're doing, Directa 68. And when the time is right, when the time is right, when we have the numbers, we're going to take the streets and we're going to bring the government down, but not before that. In this line, we're talking about Joan Vives and Sule Vicens, Anarque, Anarque, quite known. She's organized things with Shona McAlpine, with Angus Brenda McNeil here in Catalonia. Joan Vives is the ex-boyfriend of Elisenda Paluzie, which is the new leader of Assemblea Nacional Catalana, and current husband of Anarque. Anarque that was infiltrated by him. Anarque that is or was a contributor to Bella Caledonia and has been quite active in Scotland, as far as I know. These three people, Joan Vives, ex-former president of the Catalan Student Union, I was deputy president of, so I know the guy for 30 years. It took me 25 years to discover he's a mole. And his present wife, Anarquia, is also a mole that we've explained in this program. And so is Elisenda Paluzie, the former girlfriend of Joan Vives. But the relevant thing is that Joan Vives was the person that was the introducer to politics of most Catalan politicians. So outing him as a mole shows that everything is a farce, so he's a key player. I'm surprised somebody who's known by everybody in power was known by nobody in the grassroots people. But for the last year, for the last 2 years, I have been exposing him, I've been outing him. So now, bang, all of a sudden, Anarchy and Joan Vives always make a show with the 11th of September. 3 years ago, they cut the microphone to Delia and me while we were cornering Shona McAlpine in a public appearance while she was lying through her nose, and we were exposing her, and she ran away, and the Joan Vives ordered our microphones to be cut off because, well, they were being exposed in public and people couldn't have access to the truth. Can you imagine the fear? You've been lying to people, pretending you are for independence, and somebody is out there exposing you and saying you're the contrary. Not exactly another day at the office. Then, I don't know, about 2016, I didn't see them. I was still recovering from what had happened to me. In 2017, both of them, Anarquia, Joan Vives, and their little baby, poor thing, they came to harass, threaten, coerce Delia and mainly me, trying us to lie in this program, and they were almost violent in the tent we had for the 11th of September. And then this year, and it's relevant because the last time I saw the guy, he tried to run away from me, and then he said, "Oh, you're making me a main principal character in this radio program of yours." I said, "Well, but you are, isn't it?" Then they're supposed to have had a tiff inside parliament with one of the most hated unionists. I don't know, I'm not such up to date, but imagine if they had somebody that is being exposed as a mole some years ago, and then he picks up a tiff with none else than Jim Murphy. So it's gonna be the instant buddy of every independentist, isn't it? But the victory of this program has already delivered another blow. They have kept him undercover for 30 years. For 30 years, they never made him appear. It's very difficult to get pictures of him. Actually, some media have published a picture that is the same picture, almost only picture that we have of him. But thanks to this program, thanks to people listening to this program, I'm sure he gets approached every other day. But someone says, "Oh, is it true that you work for Spain?" And it must be tense. So now they've had to change their strategy. So instead of silencing him, ignoring him, they decided to clean him. Because then again, it's controlled opposition. You put him against... And you know how it goes. It's a faraway video, and you have to imagine what they say. So they can say that they might have been talking about football, but they say he threatened the other guy. He says he didn't do it. The other guy says that, and you know how it goes. Both sides now are going to prop up their heroes. So it's another victory for Radio Adrian. A lot of people are attacking me, all of them saying the same things. Lots of people are showing support in our wall. We need help to keep translating our ideas. It's half a page to every language, especially we're looking forward to having it in Gaelic. So if somebody listening to this program is capable of translating half a page of our goals in Gaelic, we'd be thankful if he gets in contact with us through all the means, all the pages we have. And we ask you to keep spreading this program because we've already managed to force them to change tack in a very important spy. A very important spy has been outed, and now they cannot hide him. They decided to change tack and try to make him a hero. But that's not easy because a lot of people know him. So now a lot of people will come out and give information about him. So, it is a success. This year, This week, we've also seen the destruction of PDeCAT doing mistakes, which is something we already advanced, that Spain would destroy PDeCAT to destroy independence. And with that, we'll go. We encourage you to send a story related to child abuse anywhere in the world. We want to make this program a reference, a humble reference, because we're not experts in this, but we are experts in telling the truth that not many people dare saying. We keep committed to Scottish independence. We keep committed to Catalan independence. We are advancing. We're winning this. We're going to win this. Visca Catalunya Lliure, Saor Aluba Gubra.
This has been another update from the Catalan independentist resistance from Radio Hadrian. Remember that you can follow us on social media, either on Facebook, YouTube, our Twitter account, Instagram, Google, Telegram, and also on iVoox.